Each airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas from the flight deck. Grand Canyon National Park is a small single runway airport located near the southeast rim of the Grand Canyon in Arizona. The airspace north of the airport's Class Delta airspace is highly regulated and restricted. Flying to GCN requires detailed pre-flight planning to become familiar with the rules and requirements to operate in and around the surrounding areas. Tour companies that provide aerial views of the Grand Canyon operate the vast majority of the traffic at the airport. The fleet mix is mostly helicopters, but does include large single and turboprop twin-engine aircraft. Military helicopters and cargo aircraft do use the airport for refueling and practice approaches. Traffic volume is seasonal, with heavy traffic periods primarily occurring during the summer months. Tower operating hours are adjusted to the seasonal traffic. Check the chart supplement for tower hours of operation. Be aware that during the summer months, density altitude may be an issue for some aircraft. Heavy snow becomes the issue during the winter months. Check NOTAMs for snow removal operations and runway closures. There is a parachuting operation on the field, and the landing zone is just southeast. The airport is temporarily closed to arrivals and departures while jumping is in progress. The runway configuration consists of a single runway labeled Runway 321. A full-length parallel taxiway with connectors is found south of the runway. The rest of the airport surface is non-movement area as noted on the airport diagram. The tower's radar surveillance system is not certified for aircraft separation, but can be used to aid the controllers in locating aircraft. However, due to radar coverage, the system is less useful to the east of the field than it is to the west. This is only mentioned to highlight the need for accurate position reports when inbound to Grand Canyon National. After landing at the airport, there are two areas for transient parking. At the far north end of the taxiway is the preferred location, while additional parking is located further south, just prior to Taxiway Charlie, in front of the General Aviation Terminal. There are some areas on the field that have contributed to pilot confusion, and in some cases, runway incursions. One such area is located at the north end of the airport. Pilots have sometimes crossed the hold short lines for runway 21 on taxiways Alpha or Bravo without a clearance. Also located in this same area is Hotspot 1. Hotspot 1 highlights the risk of pilots confusing taxiway Alpha and taxiway Bravo, which are located in close proximity to one another. The use of the airport diagram or moving map display, combined with a constant and thorough visual scan outside the aircraft while taxiing, will help mitigate this risk. There is no designated run-up area for runway 21. Contact ground for suggestions and alternatives for where to do a run-up. There is, however, a designated run-up area for runway 3. Pilots are reminded, once they enter this area, they will need the appropriate clearance from the tower to re-enter taxiway Papa. As stated earlier, there is a large non-movement area located south of taxiway Papa. The markings between movement and non-movement area are not standard. Pilots must have an ATC clearance to enter a movement area from a non-movement area. If you are ever in doubt, hold your position and ask the tower. They are there to help you. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at Grand Canyon National will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the ATC tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the Grand Canyon National Park Airport. It's always better to know before you go.